wash over me. I'm ready to lose my feet. Take me off to the place where one reviews life's mystery. Steady on down the line, lose every sense of time. Take it all in and wake up that small part of me. Day to day I'm blind to see and find how far to go. Everybody got the reason, everybody got the way. We're just catching and releasing what builds up throughout the day. It gets into your body and it flows right through your blood. We can tell each other secrets and remember how to love. Da da dum da dum dum dum. Da dum dum dum. Da dum dum. Da da dum da dum dum. Da dum dum dum. Da dum dum. Mystery. Steady on down the line, lose every sense of time. Take it all in and wake up that small part of me. Day to day I'm blind to see and find how far to go. Everybody got the reason, everybody got the way. We're just catching and releasing what builds up throughout the day. And it gets into your body, flows right through your blood. Tell each other secrets and remember how to love. Da da dum da dum dum dum. Da dum dum dum. Da dum dum. Da da dum da dum dum dum. Da dum dum dum. Da dum.
drank champagne with kings and queens. The politicians praised my name. But those were someone else's dreams, the pitfalls of the man I became. For years and years, I chased their cheers, the crazy speed of always needing more. But when I stop and see you here, I remember who all this was for. And from now on, these eyes will not be blinded by the lights. From now on, what's waiting till tomorrow starts?
Welcome back, everybody. Everybody good? Everybody fed? Yeah. What did you guys think of the food? Good food can taste good, too. Oh, hello, Liam. Does everybody know my daughter, Brinley? Yeah. Say hi. Hi. And this is Dr. Aaron. Say hi. All right. So what we're going to do now is something a little fun. We're going to give away some prizes. So everybody get your raffle tickets out. All right. So the first thing we're going to give out is a $25 gift certificate to your first order off Norwex. So, Bryn, would you like to go ahead and pick one? Is there a name on the back? Nope. All right, so let's read the numbers. Here, use the microphone.
998050.
All right, Doug, come on up and get your prize. Congratulations.
Thank you.
I need to verify. I'm just kidding. I take your word for it. Oh, I can do that too. Good job. Congratulations, Doug. All right. This one is going to be a $25 gift certificate off a beauty counter. Get a good one. Is there a name on the back? No. Wait, is that name? Nope. All right. Go ahead and read that one.
998055.
Anyone?
Anyone?
Bingo. All right. Well, all right. Let's do it again. No, don't put that back in here. I got it. I see it. Okay, read that one.
998049.
Tammy. Oh my goodness. This is rigged.
Two for two.
Congrats.
Did you bribe the ticket?
Here you are. I'm going to shake your hand, though, Tammy.
Oh, okay.
Told me to do that.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome. Congratulations. All right. Let's shake these up. This is... All right. This one is for the grand prize of our Ninja IntelliSense. And if anybody, whoever wins this, if you already have one, talk to me after. I can give you the Costco receipt, and we can get you the cash for it. All right. Is there a name in the back?
No.
Nope. All right.
998056.
Anyone?
No.
Anyone?
How's
oh, my goodness.
Come on.
Whoever left early is going to feel really bad. All right. All right. Try it again.
998060.
Oh, Yay! Christine. Congrats.
I donated mine when we
moved. Oh, perfect timing.
Donated the box.
Oh my gosh, that's awful. Congratulations. Congratulations. All right. Thank you, Miss Bryn. So I'm now going to leave you with Dr. Aaron, who's going to go over some physical activity, oxygen, and exercise.
Ooh.
All right.
Okay, y'all. I know that physical activity and exercise is sometimes a bad word, because who has the time, right? But I promise you do. It's easy. What kind of daily activities do you have? Most of us spend our days sitting at a desk. Do we ever get time to play with our kids? Do we get to get up and move? How often do we do this? Not often enough. So 60 to 85% of the population is sedentary, which isn't too shocking, I don't think. And a typical day for most people, you get up out of bed, you sit down to eat breakfast, you get in the car to drive to work, you sit behind a desk for 8 to 12 hours, you drive home, you get home and you relax on the couch for another couple hours. Does this sound familiar? Anybody? Yep. I feel like there should be more hands. There was only like 5. So they're equating sitting to being the new smoking. So if you sit for an entire day, so breakfast, work, lunch, all these things, it's the equivalent of smoking a pack a day. Shocking. This sedentary lifestyle can lead to obesity, increases risks of cancer, causes high blood pressure, and these are all things that we can easily rectify with just getting up and moving a little bit throughout our day. There were also increased incidences of depression and anxiety related to a sedentary lifestyle. So a couple solutions, standing desks, super easy. We write recommendations for it all the time. We had one business re-outfit their entire office with standing desks that made a huge difference in most of those patients' lives. So if you do work in an office who doesn't have that, come talk to us. We'll help you out. We'll write those recommendations and see if we can get you some cool new office furniture. So I guess the main question now is, do we need to move more? Yes? Good job. So some benefits of exercise, cardiovascular health, that's always good. So an easy way to kind of boost that is take a 30-minute walk after dinner. It's good family time. It's good. Your dog probably had to stay inside while you were driving around and sitting all day. So take the dog for a walk. It's easy, 30 minutes after dinner. Get that digestion process moving. And that will also decrease your risk of heart disease by 32%. That's pretty amazing. Another is a boost in mood and also help with sleep. So as long as you don't do it right before you have to go to sleep, because that won't help at all. But if you just exercise regularly there's a study of 1.2 million people done in 2018. Of those who exercised regularly, there's a less incidence of mental health issues, so depression, anxiety, and the kind of exercise that we're going to show you here today. It has been shown in study after study after study that it is more effective as an antidepressant than anything that you can get that you take orally. Just period. And so, the main problem that we have is expensive gym dues. People don't want to spend 2 hours on an elliptical because that's not fun unless you're watching Netflix the entire time, but we can do that for the other way. What we do is a 12-minute exercise, and we're going to get your heart rate way up, and we do that through metabolic conditioning. So,
thank you, Aaron. So, yes, metabolic conditioning is a very specific way of working out that changes your metabolism. So, like you said, we need to move more, right? We don't move enough. So we don't want to spend lots of money on gyms. We don't want to spend lots of money on treadmills. Have you guys tried that before? It's boring. Oh my gosh, I've been on a treadmill once before. It's awful. So instead of doing this, we don't have enough time. That's the biggest excuse that we get is, I don't have enough time to work out. We teach metabolic conditioning. It's a very specific way of working out that changes your metabolism. You only have to work out 12 minutes a day.
Easy.
Raise your hand if you've done the Max T3 workout before.
Oh,
lots of you have.
Yay.
Some of you have not yet. So what we're going to do is give you a little taste of this here today. So the reason why we work out this way is after one 12-minute workout, You burn fat for 36 hours. Now, if you were to get on a treadmill for an hour, when you're done, you have about a four-hour afterburn. With our 12-minute workout, you have a 36-hour afterburn. When you do a treadmill, cortisol levels start to creep back up very quickly. That's your stress hormone. That's one that stores the fat, can't sleep. Well, ours, with our workout, the 12-minute workout, cortisol levels go down for 36 hours. This is why it's more effective than any antidepressant on the market, like she said. All right, so it helps depression, it helps anxiety, it helps you sleep better. It also boosts your human growth hormone and testosterone, which is going to help you burn fat and build muscle. So you guys ready to try this out here today? Yes?
Yes.
Yes?
Yes.
All right, can we get some music? Yes. So what we're going to do, I want everybody to stand up.
Come on.
Where are my volunteers? Shelby, Amber, come on out here.
Come on, where are you?
What we're going to do is we're going to do squats. Does everybody know how to do a squat? A squat, and this is very easy. You have a chair right behind you. Sit down, get up. Sit down, get up. But we're not going to do it slowly. We're going to do it quickly. If anybody here has knee problems, which would be a good modification? What would you say a modification would be? Maybe not go as deep, a little bit slower maybe, but we're going to go as fast as you can. Because the whole point of this is to get your heart rate up. All right, so we need to do, let me get a timer out here. We're going to go hardcore for 20 seconds at a time. So, let me get my timer out. All right. So, when I say go, you're going to squat as fast as you can for 20 seconds. We're going to take a break, but we're going to do it three times. You guys ready? One, two, three, go!
Since I was 14 with the
fourth as fast as you can.
Good job, y'all. Keep going.
If you can, get your butt to hit the seat. Butt to hit the seat.
Labels out here. Now they can't.
The deeper you go, the better the results.
We give that to the people. Spread it across the country. Labels out here.
Keep going.
Now they can't.
Three, two, one.
Spread it across the
All right. So that was one 20-second workout.
Good job, y'all. You made it. Nobody died.
So with our workouts, we typically do what's called a super fast workout, which is 20 seconds on, 20 seconds off, 20 seconds up for 12 minutes. So you're really only working out 6 minutes. And for each three sets, you'll actually change up an exercise. So it'll be squats, it'll be lunges. But today, we only have so much room, so we're going to continue to do squats. We're going to get going here in 4 seconds. You guys ready? Three, two, one, go.
Thank you, yeah. I'm so damn grateful. I grew up really wanna go fronts, but that's what you get when Wu-Tang raised you.
Y'all can't stop
me. Go hard like I gotta eat it in my heartbeat. And I'm eating at the
beat
like it gave a little speed to a great white shark on shark. We rock. Time to go up, gone. Deuces, goodbye. I got a world to see. And my girl, she wanna see Rome. Caesar make you a believer.
Nah,
I never ever did it for a throne.
We have baby squats over here. It's a little harder. Added weight.
Oh, add the baby in. Those are weighted squats.
Yep.
That's the next level of difficulty. Yes.
You have small children. Hold them while you're squatting.
All right, this last one, we're going to have some people going out in the crowd and see who's giving it them all, their all, and give out a couple prizes for people that are doing it the best. You guys ready? Three, two, one, go!
We'll fight till it's over, so we brought our hands up like the ceiling can't hold us. Like the ceiling can't hold us.
Good job.
Give it everything you got. This is your last round.
Nice and quick. Nice and quick.
You
got it.
Good job. Give yourself a round of applause. You did good. All right, thank you guys. Appreciate your help. So how was that? Was that awful? That wasn't so bad. Got the blood pumping, and in just a short amount of time. Not that hard. Good job. So we know people that eat right. We know people that exercise. But is that a good definition of health? No, because we all know people that did those things and then died way too young. And then you all have this guy in your family, old Uncle Eddie, right? 93, shows up to every reunion and sits in the corner and just chain smokes and drinks the whiskey and won't die. You all know him, right? What is the difference? What is the difference between those two people? What happens if I cut my finger? I bleed, but what else? What's my body going to do to that cut? It's going to heal it. Everybody say heal.
Heal.
Your body is supposed to heal itself. You guys want to know what the definition of health is? I want to teach it to you. Most of you should already know it. And those of you that don't will never forget it again. Because health has nothing to do with how our body feels. Our health has everything to do with how our body heals. That's it. again, the natural state of our body is a state of health and healing. If you're not healthy, you're not healing, you don't need to say, what's wrong with me? You need to say, what's interfering with me? What is getting in the way? Why is this happening? Hippocrates, years and years and years ago, was so smart to say, look well to the spine for the cause of disease. He knew that something was up. He knew that our body was healthy. Guys, you have to understand that God put the power inside of you already. Every one of you is supposed to be healthy and healing. It starts here in the brain, runs down your spinal cord, runs along nerves to every single cell in your body. If I cut the nerve that goes to your heart, what happens to your heart? It stops working. You are now what? You're dead. Well, what if I take a bone and I shift it out of alignment, put pressure on that nerve? What happens to the heart? Does it build health or disease? Disease. So that natural state of health, that natural state of healing is called being at ease. What does it feel like to be at ease? Feel relaxing? Peaceful? Everything's doing what it's supposed to do, right? That's our natural state of health and healing. It's a state of ease. So when there's no interference between your brain and your organs are at a state of ease, which means that we should be at or near 100% of health and wellness, which means that we wouldn't have any problems. If we put pressure on this nerve, we're not at 100% anymore. We're now building a state of dis-ease. Dis-ease. If I write that out, it might look familiar. What does that look a lot like? Disease. The only difference between dis-ease and disease is who's calling it what. Diseases are just states of dis-ease. A medical doctor needs to name it so that they can diagnose it so they know what medication and how to bill. That's called disease. It's nothing more than a state of dis-ease. Because if you put pressure on that nerve, that body's not going to function. It's not going to build ease anymore. It's going to build dis-ease. If you leave that too long, now you've got a major problem in your health. Does this make sense to you? First quarter of chiropractic. We got glare. The good news is I'm not writing too much else on there. First quarter of chiropractic school, and I told a couple of you this story not too long ago. We were in philosophy class learning about this stuff. And the doctor up front says, is light real? And I'm like, yes. Is darkness real? Everybody says, no. And I'm like, yes. I'm like, oh, I like being right. My wife can tell you. I felt like an idiot. But I'm like, I don't understand. What do you mean darkness isn't real? Do you guys think darkness is real? Or is darkness nearly the... So you guys were all smarter than I was. Very good. It's merely the absence of light. And I said, that's, wow. I was blown away because I was like, that's so simple, yet I just didn't get it. And now I get it, and I'll never forget it. But what does this have to do with your body? Well, if this is your source of your light, and it's going down here at 100% light, and it's going along these nerves 100%, and it's getting to the organ's going to have 100% light in that organ. It's going to do what it needs to do. If there's pressure on this nerve, are we going to get 100% light there anymore? No. That is now allowing what to creep in? Darkness. Light. Dark. Light. Dark. What's the only way to get rid of darkness? There's only one way to get rid of darkness. What is it? Turn on the light. Shine the light. That's it. How can we put medication into this lung to fight darkness? We can't. You can't fight darkness with darkness. There's only one way to get health back in this lung. Take pressure off and allow the 100% light to get there again. And as it gets there, your body starts to regenerate. It starts to recuperate. In fact, I don't know if you guys ever heard of the Windsor autopsies. This was done in 1921 by a medical doctor who had heard of chiropractic and said, I need to prove these guys wrong. This is crazy. I don't believe this stuff. So what he did is he took 50 cadavers at the University of Pennsylvania. And these cadavers, they all died of some types of diseases. And what he wanted to do was basically find the diseased organ and trace that nerve back to the spine and see if there was a misalignment there. This is what he found out. Out of 139 organs that were diseased, out of 139, 128 of those nerves were twisted, subluxated, misaligned, pressure on them, right to the right level of where they came out. And the other 10 went to the supply right above it. So basically what he just did, he proved